Scam messages and calls in the Philippines doubled over the last 8 months compared to the previous year, despite the SIM card registration law being in effect for 2 years now. Andrea Taguines with a full story.
A 200% increase. That's how much the number of scam messages and calls in the Philippines grew these past 8 months compared to 2023, according to anti-scam app Who's Call. From January to August, the app has logged more than 3 million text scams and over 300,000 scam calls through its community reporting program. Millions more in spam messages and spam calls were also reported. According to app developer GoGoLook, the top four types of scams involved luring people into registering on phishing sites, offering fake gift cards, promoting certain apps, and a combination of job, loan, and investment scams.
Kasi ang mga scammers, kagaya nga ng sabi ni Yuse kanina, nagpo-profile sila eh. So, in other words, meron na silang idea like you are a probable target for an investment scam. You are a probable target for a loan scam.
These types of scams persist even though the SIM card registration law, which was touted as the solution to deter fraudsters, has been in effect for nearly 2 years now. But the Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center, which is under the Philippine ICT Department, insists the measure has been the shot in the arm the government needed to crack down on scam syndicates.
Bakit kami nag-ooperate ngayon? Bakit ang PAOK, ang NBI, ang PNP, practically everybody, DTI, is running after people? Kasi meron na tayong pwedeng habulin. Peke man yun o hindi, at least yung data na yun will lead us to its origin. The record shows ang dami na nating nahuli.
Ramos also expects a win for the government soon, with the looming conviction of 17 Chinese nationals arrested in Iloilo in November last year after they confessed to cyber crimes.
Yung lawyer nila ay nag-plea bargain na. Naantay na lang natin ang decision ng korte kung anong ipapataw sa kanila. And this will be the first conviction, if ever. Our law, they have to serve a sentence here, but at a shorter term.
Tapos deportation.
Then they will be deported.
But even Ramos admits the SIM card registration law needs to be updated to better address ever-evolving scam techniques.
May nagre-register na isang daang SIM card sa isang name na prepaid. Wala kasi limit ang pagre-rehistro. So, ito ay mga amendments na sinasuggest natin. Tulad yan, wala pa tayong batas tungkol sa AI.
Who's Call is promoting public awareness against scams through its app, which distinguishes between scam numbers and legitimate contacts. The app also detects malicious links embedded within texts and helps determine whether a user has been involved in a data leak.
Habang nagri-ring ang phone mo, sasabihin niya sa'yo, ah, ito, bank A. O habang nagri-ring ang phone mo, ito, outright, sinabi niya sa'yo, scammer yan. Kung laging tumatawag yun sa inyo, you can report. You can report it here para ma-investigate.
Meanwhile, the government also believes the newly enacted anti-financial account scamming law will further strengthen its cause once the implementing rules and regulations are released by the Philippine Central Bank. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
A survey by social media giant TikTok shows about 3 in 5 Filipino TikTok users have already started their Christmas online shopping this month. The app notes shoppers who are usually bargain hunting take their time researching prices and finding vouchers to save money. Some 74% of them scroll through the platform more than once a day to look for products, while 78% make weekly purchases on e-commerce platforms. The surge in online shopping orders are usually observed during the holiday seasons or the so-called Ber months, when e-commerce platforms hold mega sales. The study also shows TikTok buyers are more likely to increase their spending this year. 84% of its users purchased items on sale last year. And the Gokongwei Group's GoTime Bank has partnered with the Philippine Central Bank to enable customers to deposit their coins using BSP's coin deposit machines, converting them into interest-earning savings. GoTime is now integrated with these machines, becoming the first bank to offer this feature, allowing customers to deposit their loose change conveniently. After depositing coins, the machine generates a barcode, which can then be scanned to credit the deposit directly to your GoTime account. The BSP launched these coin deposit machines in June of last year to promote coin circulation amid an artificial coin shortage in parts of the country. Young Filipino innovators urged to participate in Austrian conglomerate Red Bull's global competition, Red Bull Basement. The initiative aims to showcase Filipino talent on the global stage. Participants from over 40 countries will compete for a chance to receive mentorship and networking opportunities in Silicon Valley. Interested individuals are encouraged to develop a concise one-page business plan and submit it via Red Bull's official website.
If it's meaningful enough, then we will see it. Mm-hmm. And if, well, if you're lucky, fortunate, and if the idea is good, then who knows, you might end up in Japan pitching in front of the world. From the initial wave of people who submit, we will narrow it down first to 20. And then the 20 will come up with a 60-minute video pitch. And then from those 20, we'll narrow it down again to 10, and then we'll have a national competition, find the national champion from those 10. And that lucky, innovative, amazing person, we will support through a two-week development program, and then we will bring them to Tokyo.
2 weeks.
The Philippine Science High School launches a blockchain-powered system for portable digital credentials, utilizing the same technology that secures cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin. PSI DigiCert will centralize student record requests and releases within the school system, allowing students to easily share their records with institutions or employers. The system is expected to be tested and potentially rolled out by the school by the end of this year or next year. PSI hopes this initiative will encourage other government agencies and educational institutions to adopt similar technologies. Meanwhile, a local publishing house launched on Wednesday what it describes as the first set of locally produced decodable texts. A total of 300 books were released by Lampada Publishing House, half of them written in Filipino, the other half in English. Decodable texts are reading materials designed to help children learn how to read. The publishing house aims to address what they refer to as the reading crisis among Filipino children. The Lampada Reads books will be available via online shopping platforms or directly through the publisher. The Philippine Statistics Authority revising its rules on late birth registrations. Late registrants are now required to apply for a national ID card before they can get their birth record. This, the PSA says, is meant to compel the personal appearance of the registrants to avoid fraudulent registrations. The agency has been in hot water recently after dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Kuo allegedly acquired a Filipino birth certificate despite being a Chinese national. The PSA also addressing the issue of the canceled contract for national IDs. The agency says it was surprised that the Banco Central subcontracted the printing to the supplier Allcart. The BSP was supposed to be in charge of actually producing the physical cards based on its 2019 agreement with the PSA. Over 55 million cards out of the 19 million registrations have already been issued, leaving a balance of 35 million more. Collectors, listen up. A rare manuscript copy of the 1898 Declaration of Philippine Independence set to be auctioned off by Leon Gallery this Saturday. Leon Gallery says the original proclamation document is safeguarded in the National Library of the Philippines. So let's talk about more about the item going up for bidding. This is actually a handwritten copy of the 12-page manuscript made by Lieutenant Colonel Jose Banuelo, a known confidant of former President Emilio Aguinaldo, on the same day, June 12, 1898. Academics guess he may have been acutely aware of the historical importance of the founding event, or may have simply wanted a copy for safekeeping in case the original was lost, or perhaps to certify his own participation in this lofty enterprise as a way of obtaining future political favors.